Thank you very much, and thanks for a great lunch. It's my pleasure to be with you today. And it's relatively strange to me that I would, if you'd told me 10 years ago that I would accept an invitation to the press club, I would have said, absolutely not. But after serving as mayor for 7 years and campaigning for 2 years before that, I certainly value the role that the press plays in the urban dialogue and the discussion of public policy. So a special thank you to you, John, and others for having me. I brought a few notes, and I thought after I make comments for 10 minutes or so that I would then we'd open it up for questions. So I have passed out I've passed out my questions. No, I'm kidding. And feel free to ask yours along with mine. The city of Atlanta is a very interesting place, both in 2009 and going back over the last decades. We are one of the fastest-growing cities in America. We're one of the fastest-growing metropolitan areas in America. And we are predicted to be the center of one of the fastest-growing mega-regions, regions outside of Atlanta, actually, regions that go as far as parts of North Carolina, Florida, Alabama, and Tennessee. So as we look at Atlanta's history, I think it's very important for us to review why have we been successful and how can we build on the success that we've had for the long term, because my assumption is that all of us here and the people who live and work and invest in Atlanta are interested in a healthy economy, a healthy city for their children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren. And that is the hard work that we do. Now, some would say that mayors, the hard work is filling the potholes, managing the day-to-day operations of the city. But I would say that the hard work is really looking out beyond the here and now into the future to make a determination as to what one must do today in order to ensure success years from now. That is the tradition of Atlanta. You can go to Mayor Hartsfield. Mayor Hartsfield and his significant role in water infrastructure with Lake Lanier, obviously with the airport. You can come forward with Mayor Allen and his very significant role during the civil rights movement and advancing air transportation in Atlanta and a close business relationship between City Hall and the business community move forward, obviously with Maynard Jackson, Andrew Young. And I have sought to continue that tradition of looking beyond the here and now. Now, what's interesting about that is that people vote for you because they want something done right now. So there's constantly this balance between how you spend your time and your resources on the here and now and how you spend your resources on the future. Well, I had a huge opportunity to do a little bit of both, and it's called the Clean Water Plan. Clearly, we had to make adjustments now, but the investment in water infrastructure will benefit the city business, and public health for at least another generation or two. And it gave me an opportunity to say we can do the here and now at the same time we are planning for the long term and for the future. The other significant thing about the water infrastructure program called Clean Water Atlanta is that no one thought we could do it except for a federal judge and some strong environmental groups. And they were absolutely insistent that the city could tackle this problem successfully. I was not in their number when I was elected in 2002. I actually thought that we would fail and that ultimately the federal government would take over the water system and Atlanta would no longer operate its own water system. But here's the good news. This community rallied around this project, one of the sexiest, you have to admit, projects that recent mayors has put forward, rallied around this project, and out of that came not just a clean water plan and a financing plan and the ability to meet the requirements of the Clean Water Act and the aspiration for a clean environment, but out of that came a can-do attitude that we have used to tackle other issues and to seize other opportunities. So in some ways, the acquisition of the King Papers, the Morehouse College collection of Dr. King's personal papers grew out of this can-do spirit that we experienced in 2003 and 2004 with clean water. I think that communities that tackle the toughest challenges in front of them are stronger to seize the opportunities that are available to them that they couldn't predict, like the acquisition of the King Papers, or the issues around human trafficking, or like the issues of transportation, which I'm sure someone will ask me about because that seems to dominate our public dialogue in Atlanta. So, where does that lead us? Having served for 7 years, and I'm not counting days anymore, but I am counting months. There are 11 months and a few days left. My job is to be sure that those projects that we have started, whether it's the infrastructure projects with water and sewer, or aviation, or the quality of life projects like the Beltline, or the Peachtree Corridor projects, or the initiatives around public education, and access to college. My job is to be sure that the momentum is sufficient enough that these projects can continue into the next administration. So you will note that when we developed plans of whether for the Beltline or the Peachtree Corridor or the Green Space Program, all of them were 10, 15, 20, and 25-year plans. And that is directly related to my experience having been in two different administrations and knowing that ideas come and go. So I wanted to find a way to develop community consensus around some long-range projects that had a chance of living once I no longer in office. So that was by design, that they were not 4, 5, 6, 8-year plans, but rather plans that would overlap. In addition to that, where do we find ourselves in 2009? And I will conclude with these comments. Where do we find ourselves in 2009? Dead smack in a recession. I came in 2002 at the end of a recession, and now again we're smack dab in the recession. So my job is to be sure that Atlanta is fiscally sound and able to weather the recession as best we can at the same time we're investing for the long term. So on a day-to-day basis, most of my interaction with the media and a lot of my interaction with the public is about the here and now. But much of my work in city government with the cabinet is about what we are going to do 10, 15, and 20 years from now.